Hello and welcome back to another video of me talking about everyone's beloved bastard teacher, aka Rokudenashi, the epic tales of Glenn the Lazy Bastard. And damn, school competition in episode 4? Come on, this is fast. But Glenn, you're a poor soul, being broke. You need money. And then there's this little bit of hope that you would get some extra money if you're responsible for the winning class of the competition. And damn, this really works. So yeah, Glenn putting up his lineup for the competition. He is choosing the students for different parts of the competition, the flying, the sniping, the, well, all sorts of events. And he didn't choose them like all the other classes of just choosing the best students and put them across all the events. But nope, he is putting the students into the event they are the best at. Those who are able to use the gravity magic really good, they are in a flying competition. The one who is good at long range precision shooting, put her into the sniping. The one who can decipher magic stuff, put her in there. Rumia with nerves of steel, how it was put in the episode, put her in the mental defense things, and so on and so on. Really entertaining, and even though it felt a little bit rushed, but still a very enjoyable episode. And damn, Glenn, you're going to pay quite a shit ton of money if you lose. Betting 3 months of the salary on your class to win, and then tricking the other teacher kind of into it. Well, not really tricking it, but the teacher was kind of pushed by his students, even though he didn't want to himself. And yeah, it's really, really funny and enjoyable. We still have some stuff going on with Rumia once again. She gets a lot of attention in terms of story. In the first episode, she was the reason that the school was attacked. Now she is once again in the focus with the queen, aka her mother. Man, just give her some rest. No need to put her into all this crazy things. But we all know it, that Glenn will just save the day in the end. And then when we got the scene of Sisti's home and the parents, damn, the father totally happy how cute his daughters are and his wife kinda breaking his neck. really enjoyable, really, really enjoyable. And yeah, Siliga, still my favorite character so far, even though she's just a support one. Kinda makes me sad. Seriously, just give her more screen time. She is awesome. No need to fight here. It's just a fact for me. But then the maid who gave the queen a new necklace. Oh, come on. It's way too obvious that she is one of the bad dudes. And the zealous dude, the commander of the, what was it, Royal Guard or something? Ah, man. Picking the obvious dudes. Yeah, well, it will be fine. But then we got two new faces at the end of the episode. One guy and one girl. The girl looks really, really cute. Well, I know who she is, and it's no secret that she is one of the main characters because of the simple fact that she shows up in the opening scene. And damn, she looks really cute. I kinda get the origami feeling from her from Day to Life, so yeah, pretty cool. Just give her white hairs and I would be sold. But yeah, all in all, a great episode. I'm looking forward to seeing Glenn kicking some asses around, the introduction of the new characters, and the conclusion with the Queen. I mean, it will just happen. No need to think that this is not the way it will be. But yeah, overall, great, great episode, really enjoyable. And I really like Glenn as a character. He's pretty cool, yeah, and an entertaining one. Anyways, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time for the Sakurada Reset review, which will be later today. So, see you later. Bye-bye, alligators.